and the benchmarks of the Node. And I've been comparing it to the Phoenix SE in some aspects, like export times in Adobe Premiere, because that's the main reason I built it, and of course exporting videos and of course streaming to Twitch as well. But the first test I did was Ada64, so here you can see the temps of the CPU, of the motherboard, of the memory as well. And they're quite okay, considering I've only got the CPU cooler in there and of course lower type GPU. So it's fairly okay, and wasn't that bad. I thought it was going to get a little bit more harder in there than it is. And of course you can see the clock speeds now as well, and why I did this was just to see the average clock speeds of different cores, and they are not that different between each core, but still there are some differences, and it was just fun to see how much difference there was between the cores. And here you can see the Heaven benchmark, and this I did just for fun. It was purely fun to benchmark this machine with the old GTX 670, so I wasn't expecting any hyper performance in gaming. But it's probably playable in 720p. So it's probably playable some games like CSGO, not GTA 5 I don't think, but still some games you can probably play in 720p. When you scale up to 1080, of course it's stuttering and it doesn't have that much FPS, and of course it's working its ass off, like you can hear the GPU fan spinning up in max RPMs just to keep things cool in there. But yeah, it was just a fun test to do. And of course the last test here is Adobe Premiere Pro export times, and I compared it to the Phoenix just because it was fun. The difference weren't that big. I thought it was going to be bigger actually. Like 13 minutes on the Node and about 8 minutes on the Phoenix. And that's okay. I think 13 minutes it's okay to export a video, and of course I could get some more performance out of that if I got the Ryzen processor. But this was stock speeds, and I'm quite pleased with it. I took the last clip, actually the Fractal, the Noctua cooler, to make the comparisons. And that clip was the last clip I did and posted, so you can watch that of course on my channel as well. But I just wanted something to export to see the different times. And I'm quite pleased with this build. I'm using it now, it's running in the background and doing some tests and stuff like that. I wanted to try a different approach. And yeah, this was just more or less fun to do and to see what kind of numbers this little machine could.